Hi everyone, we want to wish you all a very happy Easter. قوم موران من قبره, المسيح قام حقا قام. He is not here, he has risen, just as he said. Matthew 28, verse 6. By God's strength and grace, we bring to you a special production that I hope will lift up your spirits and bring you joy as we commemorate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Tonight, we invite you to leave your burdens at the cross and to rejoice in the hope that comes from Jesus' sacrifice made for us and his victory over death. The past year has proven to be a challenging one, but our God does not change. He is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Jesus' invitation remains the same. I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live. Parents and the volunteers who made all of this possible. We want to encourage all families from our congregation to have their children and their youth to join our Sunday school and our youth meetings. There are so many opportunities that we still have today to stay connected with the church. So if you are interested, please don't hesitate to contact us for more information. Lastly, we just want to give all the glory to God for giving us this opportunity, the gifts, and the time to come together to fix our eyes on our Savior Jesus Christ, the Lord of resurrection and life. And as we watch this recital, let us unite in giving the Lord all the praise and honor for victory he has given us. And now we will start with the Lord's Prayer, followed by a message from Abuna Gorgis.
Thank you. the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Christ has risen indeed, truly risen. He is not here, he has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. Yes, again the angels gives the happy news to the disciples, announcing that he had risen and changed their fear to power and persistence to continue with his message, the message of salvation to all humanity. The resurrection was and still the substantial event in the history of Christianity. Jesus risen towards contain the summaries of wishes and hopes and change the concept of life entirely before and because of the sin. The divine judgment was on the humanity with death, and he lost everything and went away far from the God. But now, with the daybreak of Sunday, resurrection's sons shout and greet each other with the great news, Jesus risen. And the answer with also two great words, truly risen. The complete evidence with the fact of the resurrection. Yes, while we live the happiness of this divine event, we live it with all its meanings to be loyal witnesses on this resurrection by our behavior, our habits. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. And for his all, the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus is the Son of God that died on the cross for us. He is the one who pays the price for our sins. He sacrificed himself to give us life. But just imagine all the people that loved Jesus and followed him, how they felt seeing him die on the cross. His mother Mary, the deep pain and sorrow she was going through, watching him suffer. His disciples that loved him followed him, how they felt when their master was humiliated. But I wonder sometimes if I was there or you were there, what would you and I have done? would we have stood by and watched him nailed to the cross? Would we have denied knowing him? Would we have abandoned him? Or would we have stood by in adoration and awe for his unconditional love?
Jesus, you did so much for me upon that cross. You could have said, no, I won't. You could have saved yourself, but instead, you saved me. You could have gone on being God's son, but instead you brought me into the presence of your Father, where I could be his child too. Nothing could be harder than to receive the whip and hang upon that cross for my sins. It's so easy for me, but so hard for you. The only explanation is love. God sent his son to take the punishment for all the thoughtless, shameful, horrible, sinful things we do. Jesus gave his life because he loved us. He took our wrath of sins with him when he was on the cross. He was innocent and we were guilty. Yet he did it because he wanted us all to get another chance. So thank you, Jesus, for letting this tired, weary, and wretched soul rise up clean and glorious with you, only you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Were you there when he rose up from the dead? Were you there when he rose up from the dead?
Lord God, you love this world so much that you gave your one and only Son.
that we might be called your children too. Lord, help us to live in the gladness and grace of Easter Sunday every day. Let us have hearts of thankfulness for your sacrifice. Let us have eyes that look upon your grace and rejoice in our salvation. Help us to walk in that mighty grace and tell your good news to the world. All for your glory do we pray. Lord, Amen.
Let no one caught in sin remain inside the lie of inward shame. We fix our eyes upon the cross and run to Him who showed great love and bled for us. Freely You bled for us. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with Him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave.
Give me victory. Jesus Christ saved and rescued my soul. My sins were cleansed because of His precious blood shed on the cross. On that cross, He took away my pain and shame to give me life and victory. Now I will confidently lift my head up high and live a victorious life. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. My Savior has risen from the grave, and I will celebrate His resurrection. He will forever be in my heart. My Redeemer lives.
The very same God that spins things in orbit runs to the weary, the worn and the weak, and the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring me victory. Now I know my Redeemer. Testify, let this life within me cry, I know my Redeemer, He lives to take away my shame, and He lives for
I can overcome by the power of His blood. My faith in Him gives me a great desire to do His will. I put my trust in Jesus to direct my life and be on my side every step of the way. Faith gives me the power to overcome my fears and the confidence to face tomorrow as I stand firm on the truth that He lives. I rejoice because He holds my life and future in His hands. I am alive because He lives.
I believe in the sun. I believe in the risen one. I believe I overcome by the power of His blood. Amen. Amen. I'm alive. I'm alive because He lives. Amen. Amen. Let my song join the one ever ends because He lives.
I was dead in the grave. I was covered in sin and shame. I heard mercy call my name. He rolled the stone away. Amen. Amen. I'm alive. I'm alive because He lives. Amen. Amen. Let my song join the one that never ends.
Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, every fear is gone. I know He holds my life, my future.
Seen filled with heartache and loss,
that have buried my heart beneath the wave. But every time his praise breaks out, dead things rise up from the ground. I will live my song inside that empty grave. 'Cause there is resurrection power when we sing the name of Jesus. Resurrection power when we raise a mighty sound. So come and let the praise get loud. Make that empty grave resound. 'Cause there is resurrection power in his name.
Dead man, come out of that grave, come out of that grave. When we sing, captives, let go of those chains, let go of those chains. When we praise, dead man, come out of that grave, come out of that grave. When we sing, captives, let go of those chains, let go of those chains. When we praise, dead man, come out of that grave, come out of that grave. When we sing, captives, let go of those chains, let go of those chains. When we praise, dead man, come out of that grave, come out of that grave. When we sing, captives, let go of those chains, let go of those chains. 'Cause there is resurrection power when we sing in the name of Jesus. Resurrection power when we raise a mighty sound. So come on, let the praise get loud. Make that empty grave resound. 'Cause there is resurrection power in his name.
Oh my Lord, by your Spirit you saved me. By your Spirit you resurrected me. By your Spirit you breathed life into me. As I rise from the ashes of defeat, I declare that the resurrected King has resurrected me. The power of resurrection and victory declares the mightiness of the King. I raise prayers to Christ my King, proclaiming his name in victory, and in his name I come alive.
The head that once was crowned with thorns is crowned with glory now. The Savior knelt to wash our feet. Now at his feet we bow. The one who wore our sin and shame, now robed in majesty. The radiance of perfect love now shines for all to see. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
The tomb where soldiers watched in vain was borrowed for 3 days. His body there would not remain. Our God has robbed the grave. Our God has robbed the grave. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrected me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrected me.
Christ our King, your perfect love could not be overcome. You placed your love on a line to bear the weight of our sins and shame, washing away our river of wrongs. Even death could not defeat you. You rose from the grave to breathe life into us. When we were drowning in darkness, you lifted us from our ashes. The power of your resurrection has resurrected us. You broke our chains and liberated us from our bondages. You have cleansed us from our wickedness. You washed our fears and held our hand. Now our fears are gone, and our future is in your hands.
The moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body cross, his blood poured out for us, the weight of every curse upon him. One final breath he gave, as heaven looked away, the Son of God was laid in darkness. A battle in the grave, the war on death was waged, the power of hell forever broken.
The ground began to shake, the stone was rolled away, his perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeat.
He is alive! Behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. He is not here. He is risen, just as he said. Mary Magdalene was the first to witness the Lord's resurrection and his victory over death. She was the first to proclaim the good news to the world. Jesus conquered death. He is not in the grave, he is alive. Indeed, the resurrected King has resurrected her. He transformed her life from the powers of darkness into his divine light, from death to abundant life. And this is her story.
I saw him as great multitudes went with him. Everyone wanted to touch even the tinsels of his garment. I asked, "Who is this man?" "His name is Jesus," they said. "He heals, he delivers, he loves, he saves to the end." I said to myself, "Who would love a woman like me, possessed and tormented by demons? Even my family abandoned me. Who would deliver me from these demons? It was my sin and shame that brought them upon me. Better not keep my hopes high. I better leave right now. But at that moment, he looked me in the eye. He called me by name, Mary. His voice pierced through my heart. My whole body started to shake and tremble. His touch and his words set me free. I felt all the demons leave. I fell to the ground, but rising again, I was a new person. It felt like a dream. Jesus, I shouted, you saved me. You delivered me. You truly love me. Now I know you are God because only you can save. You alone have power over demons. You alone can set captives free. You have become my life, my deliverance, my glory. As I followed Jesus everywhere with a thankful heart and a healed spirit, I listened to words I never heard before, words that brought life to my soul. I witnessed his great works and wonders. I served him because he served me first. I loved him with all my heart. I said to myself, I will follow him wherever he goes. I want to see more of his glory. But all this ended in a place I could never imagine. He was betrayed, beaten, scorned, and treated like a criminal. My Savior was nailed to a cross. How could they crucify the King of Glory, the man who loved, healed, and saved their children? I was shattered, consumed in deep sadness and pain in my heart. How can I have hope in this life again after he is gone? All my hopes died as they placed his body in the tomb. It died.
She's crying in the garden. She's broken in despair. She's searching for a savior, but his body isn't there. Then he says, Mary. Glory, 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 hallelujah. I will be the glory in your midst. And every knee will bow to me, and every tongue confess. Yes, all the world will worship me, and all my own.
Thank you, Lord, for freeing us from our sins and dying on the cross for us. For this Easter, Bless us and keep our minds on you every minute. Lord, forgive us for everything we have done, and help us resist temptation. Please, Lord, help us through these tough times, and keep us strong and healthy. I ask for protection to all of us, and to keep us safe. In the name of the Lord our God, we pray. Amen.
Thank you for coming down to earth and walking among us to save us by dying on the cross. I hope on Easter you remind me to stay focused and not fall into temptation. I hope also you can teach me to love others as you do, Lord. Amen.
God sent his Son to take the punishment for all the thoughtless, sinful things we do. Jesus gave his life because he loves us. His love is boundless, sweet, forever true. On Easter morn, he showed he is our Savior. His resurrection proves he is our Lord. That is why we tell you, Happy Easter. He secured our heavenly reward.
God's Son.
God.
My Savior.
Goliath.
His disciples.
Jesus and the 12 disciples.
2081.
James, Andrew,
Philip,
Matthew,
Peter,
Thomas,
Bartholomew, Simon, John,
Thaddeus.
What's the mean guy?
That's who it is.
Jesus took bread, blessed it, and said, "This is my body." Then he took a cup, blessed it as well, and said, "This is my blood."
Jesus shared his bread with the disciples and told them, "One of you will betray me."
He took a piece of bread and he broke it in part and he gave it to his disciples. And he said, "Here, this is my body." Then he took a cup of wine and then he said, "Here, this is my blood."
Like eggs, spaghetti,
noodles,
ham,
plums.
One of his disciples, his name is Judas.
Judas betrayed Jesus for 30 silver.
30 pieces of silver or gold.
12 what?
12 monies.
Because he wanted to take the money.
He wanted the silver coins.
Because they did not like him.
Bad guy.
After his arrest, he was sent to trial and to be crucified the next morning.
They beat him and they put him on the cross.
They hit him, spit him, and they put a little crown of thorns in it.
Kill him.
And then he died. Jesus was carrying a cross.
The cross.
Jesus felt very sad.
He got sad.
Sad and heartbroken because his friends left him.
The sun darkened and the rock shattered.
Storms were happening and clouds.
They put him in a tomb and rolled the stone away.
In the cave?
In the tomb.
The tomb was covered with a big rock.
A big rock.
Not the king.
Two women came to the tomb.
Three.
The angel.
Two angels.
The angel said, "Jesus is alive."
The angel said, "Don't be afraid. He has risen."
The woman rejoiced.
The woman was shocked.
Happy
and surprised.
The angel told the woman to go to the disciples and everyone else and tell them that Jesus has risen.
Go, hurry, and tell the disciples that he has risen.
That Jesus was alive?
They didn't believe them. And then two disciples went and went to look for themselves.
Jesus Christ!
Jesus!
Jesus?
Jesus came into the room of the disciples when all the windows and doors were closed.
Happy.
They said, no way!
Don't be afraid.
You're still my line.
I am alive and you can touch me.
I have rose from the dead. And I am back, and I will go to heaven. After Jesus talked to the disciples, he went to heaven.
He went to heaven with his Father.
In my heart.
In our heart.
Because Jesus is alive.
Because it's God goodness.
Jesus died on the cross for us, and he saved our sins. And he rose from the dead to give us life.
He's risen! Woo!